When you use Revit P&ID Modeler to create a 3D model, you open the P&ID drawing in a separate pane in Revit. From Revit, on the Systems tab, click P&ID Modeler. Revit searches BIM 360 Team to determine if there are any Plant 3D projects in the hubs you have access to. In the Open Collaboration Project dialog, select the BIM 360 Team hub and project where the plant project with the P&ID to model. Click Open Project. The project displays in a separate P&ID modeler pane in Revit. Typically, in a plant project, you'll have multiple P&ID drawings. In the project shown here, there's just one drawing. If there are multiple drawings and you know the name of the drawing you want to open, you can use the search box. As you start typing, the list of the drawing names is filtered. Similarly, if you want to locate a specific pipeline number to model, you can start typing the line number to filter the list of pipelines. Double-click a line number to open it. Click the home icon to return to the list of drawings. Alternatively, you can double-click the name of a drawing to open it, and it displays a list of pipelines. Let's double-click the line number 1070 to open it and begin modeling. The top pane displays a preview of the pipeline. The bottom pane displays a list of parts for the pipeline. Notice the circle to the left of the line number. A green circle indicates that the pipeline is completely modeled. A blue circle indicates that the pipeline is partially modeled. To the left of each part listed, a vertical bar will change color to indicate the part's status. The bar changes from gray to green as each part in the pipeline is successfully modeled. Each pipeline from the P&ID includes information about the equipment and other elements that Revit uses when modeling. Typically, when you model a generic piping layout in Revit, you need to provide information about size, type of pipe, and the system it is assigned to, and so on. When you use P&ID Modeler, the process for modeling pipelines is streamlined. Click the Settings icon to locate the P&ID Settings dialog and manage the mappings between elements in the P&ID and the Revit model. Let's start by setting up services on the System Type tab. In this particular P&ID, only one service is used, so we'll map this P&ID service to a Revit system type. For the purpose of this video, a general process system type has been added to Revit. As you model lines from the general process service in the P&ID, they will be assigned to the general process system type in Revit. Use the Object Mapping tab to map pipe elements, accessories, and equipment. For pipelines, the primary line segment is the only one that is used in this P&ID. Let's associate this line segment with the CS300 pipe type in Revit. Next, let's move on to the Pipe Accessories tab. You'll notice that some automatic matching has been set up between the P&ID pipe accessories class names and Revit families. In this example, the butterfly valve, the check valve, and the gate valve in the P&ID are automatically matched to Revit families. These are highlighted in green. You can always override those if needed. For now, we won't make any modifications, so we'll accept those defaults. Let's follow a similar process on the Equipment tab. Notice the automatic matching between the P&ID equipment class names and the Revit families that are loaded within the project. Again, those are highlighted in green. Finally, the last group of settings we need to take care of are under property matching. Currently, only the P&ID tag property is brought in from the P&ID. You can map the property tag to whatever Revit shared parameter is associated with that particular category. For example, equipment category, we'll use a Revit shared parameter called P&ID tag. We can use the same one for pipe accessories as well. Click OK to accept those changes and close the settings dialog. Back in the drawing area, as you start modeling, You'll see how these settings really streamline the process.